a poet, and he fooled me with a lot of the songs in that, like a song like a Stone, I thought it was a love song. The chorus is, "I'll wait for you there like a stone, I'll wait for you there alone." And I was like, "Well, yo, bro, what are you waiting for?" And he's like, "Waiting to die." And I just went, oh, okay. That changes everything. I went back and looked at the song, and I got kind of saddened by what he's singing about. It's like a guy waiting alone in a house of death, and all his friends are dying, and he's just waiting there, and I'm picturing this man in a rocking chair, like, waiting to die. And it changed everything for me, and that made me go back and look at all the songs, and made me go back and look at Temple of the Dog songs and Soundgarden songs and everything, and I started going, okay, I get Cornell now, and he's a genius. He fooled me for 15 years, you know, where I maybe thought some of the things that he was singing about were slightly trivial, but they're never trivial. He's deep. He's really deep.
The band, of course, having written a lot of songs together, and then having a new guy who was influencing those songs, was really ready for a pretty big change.
I just remember being in the studio for hours a day and not getting tired, not getting bored, and sort of an outpouring of, you know, four souls making music.
We began to get this feeling of this real confidence in that rehearsal studio when we were writing those songs.
It started the process of really kind of blowing the whole thing open.
I'm wondering how our record is going to sound when we play the entire record on stage.
These are songs that deserve to be rocked live. When we listened back to our record, we thought that we had made a record that was at least as ambitious as some of our favorite records.
It's one of those dream band situations that a musician thinks about. Like, wouldn't it be great if I just met these guys that I get along with, that are on the same page as me musically, and it seems to be just effortless to write a bunch of great songs.
From, you know, the first time that we jammed, there was a chemistry between the four of us that was there, and that is not an easy thing to find. You can find someone who's great, but when you put them in a situation, if the chemistry's not right, it's not going to be good. And so I feel very fortunate that, one, we got one of the greatest singers, and two, the chemistry worked.
All that together at that moment made me breathe a sigh of relief, you know, and I was like, wow, there's a future here that's pretty bright.